हाय फ्रेंड्स, गुड इवनिंग। दिस इज़ डॉक्टर हरिनाथ रेड्डी, डायरेक्टर शंकरन आई ए स्टडी सर्कल। इन द अर्लियर वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन डिटेल द जजमेंट ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश हाई कोर्ट ऑन कंपलसरी इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल एजुकेशन। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द जजमेंट ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश हाई कोर्ट with respect to the removal of the state election commissioner in the recent past. See, after Nimmagadda Ramesh Kumar was removed as the state election commissioner, several petitions were filed before the Andhra Pradesh High Court. So Nimmagadda Ramesh Kumar himself became the petitioner, and so the case is known by the name Nimmagadda Ramesh Kumar versus State of Andhra Pradesh. So in this case, Andhra Pradesh High Court said the removal of the state election commissioner by government of Andhra Pradesh is invalid. This is what the Andhra Pradesh High Court has said, and it also gave direction for reinstating the earlier state election commissioner into office. But government of Andhra Pradesh preferred to file a special leave petition before the Indian Supreme Court. See, special leave petition is nothing but a special permission, asking special permission from the Supreme Court for admitting a case. And the government of Andhra Pradesh also tried to file a petition before the Andhra Pradesh High Court as well for staying the implementation of the High Court order. But with the admission of the special leave petition before the Supreme Court, government of Andhra Pradesh withdrew the petition asking for staying the order of High Court. Then what are the observations made by the Andhra Pradesh High Court with respect to removal of the state election commissioner? And while filing the special leave petition before the Supreme Court, Andhra Pradesh State Advocate General Sri Ram said that there were several ambiguities in the High Court judgment, so they were going before the Supreme Court. Then one important argument made by Andhra Pradesh High Court, which seems to be erroneous, incorrect, is that appointment of state election commissioner under Article 243K Clause 1, it is a discretionary power of the governor. And this is absolutely erroneous, because at the union level, the chief election commissioner and other election commissioners are appointed by the president on the aid and advice of the council of ministers headed by the prime minister. Same applies even at the state level when it is not clearly spelled out in the Indian constitution under Article 243K. India being a parliamentary democracy, you know all that in a parliamentary democracy there are two kinds of executive, nominal executive, a real executive. At the union level, president is the nominal executive, the cabinet headed by prime minister is the real executive. Similarly, at the state level, governor is the nominal executive, the cabinet headed by chief minister, the council of ministers headed by chief minister is the real executive. Unless otherwise clearly spelled out in the constitution, the governor cannot act in his discretion. In Article 243K Clause 1, nowhere it was mentioned that the governor can act in his discretion. And that too, India being a parliamentary democracy, and we have parliamentary democracy both at the union level and at the state level, it becomes very clear that while appointing the state election commissioner, the governor shall act on the aid and advice of the council of ministers. But here the High Court says the power of the governor to appoint the state election commissioner is a discretionary. There is no such discretion to the president of India, that's what the court says. So this cannot be correct, and the Supreme Court may correct this view of the Andhra Pradesh High Court. In addition to this, Andhra Pradesh High Court also said that the changes in Andhra Pradesh Panchayat Raj Act reducing the tenure of the state election commissioner from 5 to 3 years is done through an ordinance which was accepted by the governor. And ordinances are issued under Article 213. either at the union level or at the state level, for giving an ordinance, for issuing an ordinance, there are two requirements which are compulsory. The first requirement, the legislature shall not be in session. So this was fulfilled in the state of Andhra Pradesh in the context of passing amendments to the Andhra Pradesh Panchayat Raj Act through an ordinance. But the second requirement, that is the purpose of immediate action or emergency, it is not met. That's what the Andhra Pradesh High Court says. There is no larger public interest involved. There is no constitutional necessity of immediate action. So the ordinance issuance under Article 213, it is erroneous, it is on extraneous grounds, it is on oblique reasons. So the ordinance which was issued remains, stands invalid. This view may be correct because for issuing an ordinance for any reason on the aid and advice of the Council of Ministers headed by Chief Minister at the state level, apart from the legislature not being in session, the second most important requirement is that there shall be a purpose of immediate action. High Court says that there is no purpose of immediate action, so the ordinance issues is invalid, and so the changes made, and so the changes which are made through ordinance were also invalid. Even earlier in a number of judgments, the Supreme Court said all the ordinances which are issued, which are promulgated without fulfilling these two requirements remain constitutionally invalid. And then remember, this entire controversy came in the background of the unilateral decision taken by the earlier state election commissioner regarding the postponement of elections to the local bodies. So ideally, as per the conventions which were established over a period of time, before a decision can be taken by the state election commissioner, he must have consulted the state government. Though the advice of the state government is not binding, though the state election commissioner can act independently on his own wisdom, but there is a conventional requirement that he should have consulted the state government. So he neither consulted the state chief secretary nor health department officials, and without doing this, he postponed the elections to local bodies. The reason which he has given, that the corona is spreading, may be very genuine, but he not following the convention of consulting the government is incorrect. But just for that reason, he cannot be removed just by amending the Andhra Pradesh Panchayat Raj Act through an ordinance. The reason being, the removal of the state election commissioner can be done only through impeachment by the parliament, like the judge of the High Court. But here, such a procedure is not followed, and that's what the Andhra Pradesh High Court as well said. So the removal of the state election commissioner can be only through impeachment of the parliament on the grounds of proved misbehavior and incapacity. Just by making amendments through the existing Andhra Pradesh Panchayat Raj Act, the state election commissioner cannot be removed. But because if this is the way the state election commissioner can be removed, then we cannot ensure independence in the working of state election commission. We cannot ensure that the state election commission works in an autonomous and independent manner. So no doubt the removal of the state election commissioner in the manner done by the present government may not stand the scrutiny of the Supreme Court. But obviously the observations made by the High Court may be undone by the Supreme Court. The following observations, which I said earlier, that the power of governor to appoint the state election commissioner, it is a discretionary power, which is not true, and this can be undone by the Supreme Court. And the second one, the ordinance was issued even without a purpose of immediate action, may stand the scrutiny of Indian Supreme Court. In addition to this, Andhra Pradesh High Court also made one more incorrect interpretation of the provisions of the Constitution. So the Andhra Pradesh High Court says that Andhra Pradesh state legislature does not have the power to prescribe the eligibility of the state election commissioner to get appointed and even to prescribe the manner of appointment. So this view may not be correct because at the union level, parliament always had the power to decide all these issues with respect to the appointment of chief election commissioner and other election commissioners. Similarly, at the state level, the state legislature shall have the power to decide to prescribe the eligibility and the manner of appointment. But Andhra Pradesh High Court clearly, very unambiguously says that the Andhra Pradesh state legislature doesn't have this power. This may not be true. This may not be true because in India, which is a parliamentary democracy, the concerned state legislature, both at the union level and the state level, shall have such a power to prescribe, because if the constitution is silent on certain aspects, this silence can be filled in by the respective legislature providing the details which are missing in the constitutional law. So here again, the view given by the Andhra Pradesh High Court may not be agreeable to the Supreme Court. So this is what I am expecting from the Supreme Court. Then probably at the end of the day, when the matter goes before the Supreme Court may interpret this way. One, the removal of the state election commissioner through amending the Andhra Pradesh Panchayat Raj Act through an ordinance, reducing the tenure from 5 years to 3 years, might be constitutionally invalid. So this cannot be allowed to happen, because if that is allowed to happen, the autonomous and independent working of the state election commissioner will get undermined, and so the purpose of Article 243K will not be served. So obviously the removal of the state election commissioner cannot be taken in any way other than through impeachment by the parliament on the ground of proved misbehavior and incapacity. So it cannot be done in so easy way like what was done in the state of Andhra Pradesh. So there, the removal may not stand the scrutiny of the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court might say that it is constitutionally invalid to remove the state election commissioner without the impeachment of the parliament. So they say, so there, the judgment of the Supreme Court may go against what the state government wants from the Supreme Court. But the views of the state high court saying that the power to appoint the state election commissioner for the governor is discretionary may not stand judicial scrutiny. And again, the state legislature doesn't have the power to prescribe eligibility and also the manner of appointment, again may not stand the judicial scrutiny of the Supreme Court. So these two issues may be corrected in the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court may undo what the High Court has done. So that's it about the judgment of Andhra Pradesh High Court on the removal of the state election commissioner. Earlier, I had discussed in detail the constitutional and legal provisions with respect to appointment and removal of state election commissioner, and also several important cases decided by the Supreme Court and even a High Court with respect to the state election commissioner, removal of state election commissioner. So friends, you can refer to that earlier video for all the constitutional details and the legal details with respect to state election commissioner, his appointment and removal. Thank you.